Good morning, beautiful people. Michelle here from Soulshine Yoga and Reiki. And I have a little bit of time in between classes, and I thought I would share a really nice, gentle practice. It won't be too long, but mostly designed for rebalancing both sides of the body. Nurturing your body and your breath. And just really being present for a few moments. We'll tune in, so if you want to join me, hands together, heart center. Tuning in can be a really nice way to just come into the present moment, set your intention for this practice, as well as just connect to the lineage of student to teacher, teacher to student, all the way back. That said, Sat Nam, and we'll go ahead and begin starting on our back in a supine position. For the moment, your knees can be bent or open, but mindful that the spine is nice and long. Shoulders are gently retracted towards the spine. It's a small movement. Makes a big difference. You'll feel the heart really open up. Shoulders roll back into the mat. Checking in that the spine is nice and long. And that the hips and sacrum are evenly rooted into the mat. We're just going to take a few breaths here, settling in. And as you bring your awareness to your breath, you can begin to deepen and soften the breath. Counting how long your inhale is and extending the exhale by one or two. So if you inhale to three, exhale to four or five. Following the breath into this present moment. Done the round of breath you're working on, returning your breath to your own rhythm, reaching overhead with the arms and hands, and in the opposite directions with the legs and feet, as if you were being pulled in two different directions, getting a nice long body stretch. Then keep breathing. On your next exhale, bringing the knees in towards the torso for a nice hug of the knees. Hands find your shins and hug your legs into your belly. Feet can be active if that's comfortable, pushing through the feet, the ball of the foot and the heel of the foot. And I like to spread the toes. Chin slightly tucked. One more breath here. Bringing the arms to your side, extending the feet up towards the ceiling. Again, the shoulder blades are still tucked into the mat. Slung spine, hips evenly rooted. Active feet reaching towards the ceiling. Having a few breaths here in, legs up the wall. Fanning the feet away from each other and beginning to do scissor kicks from side, for each side. One leg going in an opposite direction of the other. Really opening up the inner thigh. We're gonna have a couple more. Keep breathing in a soft face. Bring your feet back into a stationary, legs up the wall. Next exhale, hugging the knees back in towards the chest. Having a breath here. Bringing the feet to the mat, keeping the knees bent. We're going to go ahead and we're going to bring the bottom of the feet towards each other. We're going to open up into this really nice butterfly pose here. Sometimes it's called cobbler. I like to put my hands on the inside of the thigh and just create a little bit of assisted range of motion. Not really pushing, just a little bit of weight. Having a few breaths here, really allowing that inner thigh to open up. Notice the breath filling up the belly. We will have one more full breath right here. And I like to bring my hands to the outside of my thighs and just give my knees a little bit of assisting back into a neutral position. We want the knees over the ankles and they're tracking with the hips, so they are about a hip width. That sacrum and hips evenly rooted, nice long spine, evenly rooted shoulders, soft face, breath or two right here. Lifting the feet up and keeping the knees above the hips and beginning to rock from side to side. Really allowing yourself to take your own time, but keep breathing and just giving yourself that nice slow massage of that back and sacrum area. And keep breathing. Couple more to each side. And mindfully, when you cross through center, pausing there and bringing the feet back to the mat. Checking your alignment is still nice. Evenly rooted hips and shoulders, long spine, knees tracking with the hips, so they're hip width above the ankles. And we're going to take the right ankle, just above the right ankle, to just below the left knee. Mindful to never stack on a joint. If you want to add on lifting that left knee towards the ceiling or torso, threading your hands around either side of that left leg. You can clasp on the outside of the thigh or the shin or under the thigh. And we're gonna have a few breaths here, and your chin is slightly tucked. Active feet if that's comfortable. If your hip is tight, like a lot of hips are, we don't wanna push too far. We just wanna find that point of sensation. Have that conversation with the hip, just to release a little bit more. It's okay to lengthen and soften. Another breath or two here. Mindfully releasing the bind of the hands. Left foot comes to the mat, right comes to follow. Checking in, alignment is good. Evenly rooted hips this time, just above the right, the left ankle comes to just below the right knee. Mindful to never stack right on a joint. If you want to add on, lifting that right knee towards the ceiling, active feet on both feet, and then go ahead and thread that needle if you'd like. Having a few breaths here, maybe noticing the difference between the two hips, a different amount of tension, maybe one was tighter or is tighter. Again, taking the moment while we're breathing here to have the conversation with the hip that it's okay to soften, it's okay to lengthen, it's okay to let go. Another breath or two. If you clasp the hands, release them, bringing that right foot to the mat, left does come to follow. From the nice evenly rooted shoulders, long spine, and evenly rooted hips, mindful that the knees are tracking with the hips above the ankles. On an exhale, when you're ready, pushing up through the feet, really through the legs, lifting the torso up, hips up, buns up. If you want to walk the shoulder blades towards each other and clasp your hands underneath your thighs and your hips, that you can do that. Chin does stay tucked. And breathing here, I love to notice in this pose my front belly filling up on the inhale. And the contraction on the exhale. Another breath or two, mindful that the knees stay in line with the hips and that they don't fall out to the sides. If you've taken the bind, release your hands and gently, slowly, one vertebra at a time, on an exhale, come back to your mat. This is an extremely slow and controlled movement. Take the time to notice each vertebra coming to the mat. Maybe you're just now getting to those lower vertebra. Sacrum and hips are still up, low vertebrae coming to the mat, and just release the hips when they get there. Taking that breath and that pause. We are going to go ahead and transition to standing. And I like to do that sometimes by vertical rock and rolls. And so you can either just, not to standing, to seated, you can just transition to easy seat and we'll all meet there. Otherwise, join me in some really nice rock and rolls from head to toe. Mindful, this is a quiet movement. We don't want to drop anything. And again, you're feeling each of the vertebra. You're not rushing. Keep breathing. And on this last one, if you want to cross your legs and come up, You can go ahead and do that, and we'll all meet here in a nice, easy seat. I like to emphasize comfort and ease in the body in my classes. So if in the event easy seat, they call this isn't always easy, becomes uncomfortable, you can go ahead and kick a leg out and just find comfort in your body. Settling in here into whichever seated pose you've chosen. Mindful that the hips, the seat bones are evenly rooted into the mat, adjusting if you need to any flesh. Really take that time and find that evenly rooted hip bones and that neutral pelvis. Inhaling length through the spine, exhaling softness through the shoulders, gently back and away from the ears, and softness in your face. On your next inhale, arms come wide and high. Exhale, right hand to the mat, left reaches over for a really nice side bend, breathing here for a breath. If you choose on your next exhale, you can twist and gently look towards the ceiling. Not necessary, but it is a beautiful heart opener. Couple breaths wherever you are. On your next exhale, if you've twisted up, return the torso, but stay in the lateral stretch. Then on the inhale, mindfully, everything comes up. Exhaling over, left hand to the mat, right reaches over, really finding the length in the long side of the body, not crunching the short. Welcome to stay here on that exhale. Gently look up, finding that heart opening twist, having a breath or two, maybe a gentle smile. Next exhale, returning the twist to forward, staying in the lateral stretch. On the inhale, everything comes up. Exhale, arms wide, gently look up, back bend. It's a small movement, be mindful of your neck. Keep breathing. Next inhale, arms come high, face comes to neutral. Exhale, follow through into your version of a forward fold. Hands come to the mat or the floor. The movement in your forward fold is coming from the low part of the hip. So breathing here, keeping that nice long spine as if your heart was being pulled forward. Your gaze can be at the floor. Breathing here, creating length with every inhale. Folding into your fold on the exhale. Remember, nice long back. Next inhale from that nice flat back as if you were being lifted from the back of the crown of the head. Everything comes high, hands high, palms facing. Exhale, palms together, drawing it towards heart center. We're going to go ahead and we're going to transition onto a tabletop position, coming onto all fours. And as we do come onto all fours, your toes can be tucked or untucked. We want our knees to be under our hips, and our wrists to be under our shoulders. And again, toes can be tucked or untucked. Okay, really pushing through the palms of the hands. Your gaze is at your mat. And from this nice flat back, on your next inhale, the face moves upward as well as the low part of the tailbone. Exhale, face looks towards your mat, and the tailbone moves towards your mat. Inhaling, face and tailbone move upward. Exhale, face and tail move down. Continuing at your own pace, mindful to link the movement with the breath. Just a couple more. And the next time you cross back through neutral, pausing in a nice stable table, gaze is at the mat, really pushing through the hands, stepping the knees back a couple inches, tucking the toes, and on your next exhale, pushing the hips up and back. Your knees can stay bent. What you're looking for is that nice long line from your hips to your wrist. If you can keep that nice long line and have your legs straight, then you can straighten, but we're looking for that long line from the hips to the wrist. You can go ahead and bend one knee and then the other, walking your dog gently, maybe finding some movement that you need, maybe bringing the hips from side to side. Whichever you choose is perfect. And then finding that nice stationary dog, slightly bending the knees and walking the feet towards the hands. Exhaling deeper into that forward fold. Hands to shin, inhale, rise halfway. Gaze is at the floor. Exhale, fold again into your forward fold. Inhaling, hands wide and high. Palms together, exhale, drawing up towards heart center. Grounding down here for a moment. Finding that nice length through the whole body as if you're being lifted from the back of the crown of the head by a string. Feet nice and pushing into the earth. Neutral pelvis, drawing that belly button slightly towards the spine. Inhale wide and high. Slightly bent knees. Exhale, pivot from the low part of the hips into your version of forward fold. Stepping back with the left foot. Right knee is bent above the ankle. Left hand is planted under the shoulder next to the right foot, a few inches away. On your next exhale, that right arm comes up towards the sky. You're finding that nice twist, pushing through the feet, breathing here. On your next exhale, your right hand comes down. It sweeps on the inside of that right foot. The feet swivel so that the toes are facing forward. Now we're in this nice wide like forward fold, having a breath or two right here. Just continue breathing. Now the toes are going to point towards the left. That left knee bends above the ankle. The right leg is extended. The right hand comes to the inside of the left foot. It's about 4 inches away, whatever's comfortable. Wrist is under the shoulder. Next exhale, twisting, reaching up with that left hand. Fingers towards the sky, or maybe just off to the side. Wherever you are is perfect. And we're having a few breaths right here. Nice soft face, maybe a gentle smile. Keep breathing. Plant the right hand next to the left foot on the outside of the left foot. Right hand comes a little bit to the side of your mat. Stepping back with the left foot into plank. Having a breath. Exhale, knees gently down, untucking the toes. And the whole body comes to follow. Coming onto your forearms. Your elbows will be underneath of your shoulders. Feet can be as wide, a little wide, maybe as your mat, or find comfort. We're really going to be pushing down through the pelvic region and stretching that heart forward. Sphinx pose, having a breath or two here. On your next exhale, releasing the hands, bringing the forehead to the mat, hands come, wrists under shoulders. We're going to go ahead And we are gonna tuck the toes. Knees can stay down. We're gonna use the arms to push up. Knees might still be down. If they are, go ahead and push them up. Hips come up, buns come up into down dog. And we're gonna have another breath right here. We'll come into a nice stationary dog. We're gonna go ahead and lift the right foot up, get a nice stretch. Maybe bend the knee so your heel comes towards your buns. And then maybe the knee comes out to the right and up. Returning mindfully everything back to down dog. Again, finding that nice long line between your hips and your wrists. This time the left leg comes up. Nice stretch, maybe bending that heel towards the buns and then bringing the knee out towards the left, really opening up that side body. Another breath, keep breathing. Mindfully bringing everything back into down dog. That left leg comes parallel to the right. From slightly bent knees, beginning to walk the feet towards the hands, exhaling into that forward fold. Inhale, rise halfway. Your gaze is at the mat, flat back. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale, wide and high. Palms together, exhaling to heart center. We're going to challenge ourselves with a little bit of balance. And I think we can go ahead and play with warrior or warrior three. It's always fun. So really grounding down through mountain before you do any balance. It's really nice to, I think, take notice of the line of gravity, lines of gravity holding us to this earth. Finding that length through my whole body, softness in my face and my shoulders. Bringing my hands to my hips. Switching the weight onto the right leg as I'm breathing, really pushing that foot down. Stepping back with the left toes. If you want to add on from here, pretending this back leg is connected to the torso, just begin tipping the torso. And that leg will come along for the ride. And you can choose any mudra you like. Active foot on that back leg is nice. Having something to gaze at is helpful. Breathe. Coming back into mountain, grounding down, connecting with the earth's gravity, holding us to the planet. This time, bringing our hands to the waist, shifting the weight onto the left leg. We're going to go ahead and step back with the right, really pushing through that left foot, and again, tipping the torso when you're ready. And just bringing that back foot along for the ride. Find something to gaze at. Keep breathing. Pushing through that standing leg. Mindfully making your way back to mountain when you're ready. One more moment here in mountain. Hands wide and high. Exhale, pivot from the hips, slightly bent knees, planting the hands. We're going to go ahead and bring the knees back to the mat, crossing the feet underneath the buns and bringing them out in front of us. We are going to come into what I was taught as cosmic egg. So as we hug our knees in, we walk, hop our toes towards our hips and heels, and then kick the feet up so that we're just right here balancing on our sit bones. Our torso is nice and tucked in with our knees. And so we're just gonna breathe here. another breath or two, let's find a plate of balance at a different center of gravity. From here, bringing the hands to under the thighs and kicking up into boat, or your version of boat. We want to keep the spine long, the torso towards the thighs as much as possible. This is a great time to play with balance. Can you take your hands off? Do you want to try? Maybe you just want to try one at a time. Maybe you want to alternate. Wherever you are is perfect, and just having a few breaths here. Feeling strong in both. I am going to invite you to take a slow boat with me to Shavasana. And if you want to transition to laying on your back another way, that's perfect too, and we'll all meet there. Otherwise, join me in a really slow boat to Shavasana. And we're just going to work it as slow as we possibly can. Right now, almost every muscle is active. It's tight, it's active. We're slow boat. To when you hit the mat, just release everything. Slow. When you get there, just let it all out, let it all go. I will guide you through some relaxation and some quiet. And I invite you, if you would like to stay in Shavasana after I close us out, please do. It's such a gift. As we settle into Shavasana, I like to move into it with a little bit of breath work. One of my favorite breaths is the 3-7. I will guide us. It's a 3-count inhale, 7-count exhale. If at any time you just need to breathe your own rhythm, please do. We'll all begin with an exhale together. Inhale, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Inhale, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Inhale, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Return your breath to your own rhythm. Mindful that the shoulder blades are gently falling to the mat. Hips are evenly rooted, nice long spine. Palms up or down, 6 to 8 inches from your sides. Feet towards the corners of your mat. Bringing softness and awareness to your toes. And allowing them to just fall heavy into gravity. Bringing that softness and awareness through the top and the bottom of the foot. And allowing them to just fall heavy into gravity. Noticing where the heel is attached to the mat. And allowing it to sink deeper. Bringing softness and awareness to the shins and the calves. Allowing the calf to sink deeper into the mat and the shin to sink deeper into the hamstring. Bringing awareness and softness to the front and the back of the knee. Bringing that softness and awareness to the thighs, allowing the hamstring to sink into the mat and the quad to sink deeper into the hamstring, softening through the whole pelvic region, all the organs, softening through the low ribs, the middle ribs, and the upper ribs, bringing that softness and awareness through the belly to the heart center. Having a few breaths here, noticing the space that's created with every inhale. And just release everything that doesn't serve with the exhale. Again, noticing the space created on the inhale in the heart area. Just releasing everything that doesn't serve on the exhale. Softening through the shoulders, both sides of the upper arm, front and back of the elbow, forearm, wrists, and each fingertip. Bringing that softness and awareness back through the arms, through the shoulders, to the neck, and allowing it to just let go, nothing to hold, surrender into gravity. Bringing awareness and softness to your face, allowing the low jaw to gently fall away from the upper jaw, and the tongue to gently fall away from the roof of the mouth. Softening your cheeks, your forehead, your eyes, and eyelids. Softening your ears, the back of the head, and the whole crown of the head. Allowing the whole back body to sink deeper into gravity, and the front body to sink deeper into the back body. Deeply relax. Bringing your awareness back to your breath, or just turn this video off and enjoy Shavasana. Otherwise, for those of us about our day mindfully, make your way to a nice, easy, seated position. Palms together at heart center. Gentle bow of your gaze or your face. Taking a moment here to notice how you feel now in your body. How does your breath feel now? I like to end every practice with gratitude. Gratitude for this practice, for my teachers, each of us to be grateful for our bodies and everything it does for us and that we have been through in this lifetime. Expressing gratitude, each of us, for our breath, the one thing that truly does link us all, from the first to the last. And most of all, I like to express gratitude for you for practicing with me. May the longtime sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. Sat Nam. Sat Nam. Sat Nam. Namaste, dear ones. Thank you so much for practicing with me.